Felons' fees are back front and center in a Florida courtroom today. Attorneys say a state law that requires felons to pay fees before they can vote impacts women of color and the poor the most. They said the law essentially denies them the right to vote after voters approved it.
Last year, the 11th Circuit Court of Appeals upheld Florida's requirement that felons must pay all fines, fees, and restitution before being able to vote. The court ruled the financial obligations were a punishment for a crime, not a tax.
We brought additional claims that go beyond just their wealth.
Nancy Abudu with the Southern Poverty Law Center is representing Rosemary McCoy and Sheila Singleton. According to court documents, the Jacksonville women owe a combined total of more than $24,000 in fees and restitution.
It's unrealistic in our client's situation.
Attorneys are now making the case that because women, particularly women of color, are less likely to be able to afford to pay, the Florida law violates the 19th Amendment.
You have one-fourth of Black women who are living below the poverty line. You have 43% of Black women who have a criminal conviction who are unemployed.
A judge has already rejected that argument, saying the law has a greater impact on men who are incarcerated at much higher rates. But Abudu says that misses the point.
It didn't take into account the disproportionate number statistically of women who are in the criminal justice system and therefore face harder burdens.
The women hope the appellate court will strike down Florida's law based on today's hearing, or that it will at least send the case back to the district court to reconsider that 19th Amendment argument.
The For the People Act, which Democrats are trying to pass through Congress, may moot the whole case. It would require felons' voting rights be restored as soon as they are released from prison. Florida is one of only a few states that doesn't already do that.